If you want to learn today how you can create MySQL RDS database server in AWS and connect to it from everywhere in the world, you are in the right place. Feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel because we're going to have more amazing content about AWS. Okay, so let's start. Open your AWS Management Console and go to RDS. Once you are in the RDS console or dashboard, there is few places that you can click in order to create your database. You have the top button, or you can just go to all the database RDS instance here right now and just click create database. As you can see, you have standard create and you have easy create. I'm gonna show you the standard create is the most common one. You can see that you can choose between six different databases. I'm gonna show you with MySQL, the most the most common one, the one that everybody almost use. Okay, the template, we're gonna choose the free tier because it's free and it's for testing and you're not gonna pay for it if you have like a new AWS account. The production version gives you option to do multi-availability zone. It's good if you're running production environment. And also what I love, in each step you can click the info link and you can get more detail about the setting. So here I'm gonna define the RDS name. And then you're defining the username and the password, so you will know how to connect to your RDS MySQL database server. Here you can choose the database instance class. If you need more power, more CPU, more memory, this is the place. We are using the free tier, so we're gonna use the free tier setting. Also here, if you want a stronger server, use the second option, the provision IOPS. It's better for performance. I'm gonna use the GP2 at the moment. You can also set the storage amount. And what I love about AWS RDS is giving you the option to auto-scaling by itself when it's hitting specific threshold. Okay, here I'm gonna use the default VPC, default subnet, and here we need to make it public. Otherwise, we won't be able to connect from outside, only from the inside of the VPC. Okay, so set it to public. I'm gonna create a new security group in order to allow specific IP to access to the RDS server. And here we can set a different port if we want. The password database identification will be the regular one, username and password, but you can choose different option. And here we have additional setting. If you want to change a specific stuff like the database parameter group, it's good. If you want to do extra setting, the backup window, how long you want to backup, other stuff like encryption, the default is going to be encrypt, so it's going to make sure if someone's stealing your database, it's encrypt. Okay, you also can activate the log option, and then from CloudWatch you can see all the log of the MySQL server, so you can monitor and make better performance. And this is the maintenance windows. Just leave it at default. If you want to change it in the future, then change. This setting is basically very important. You don't want to have the option to allow other people to delete your database. And it's going to be free for us. We're going to click the create button. Okay, so now we just need to wait for the database to initialize itself, to create itself. Okay, let's see if the database initialized in order for us to get the endpoint, the URL of the database. Okay, perfect, it's initialized. And in the meantime, I'm gonna basically download a sample of MySQL database, okay? Like data in order for us to import. Okay, you can go to this link and you have like a few options of database that you can download and play with it. I'm gonna use the one that's related to the world database. Let's open the zip file we just downloaded and extract the content. Okay, so this is the the SQL file. Let's open my MySQL client. I'm using TablePlus. I'm gonna show you how to connect to your RDS with MySQL client, and also from AWS EC2. Okay, you're gonna get two options to connect to your AWS RDS today. So let's create a new connection. We're gonna choose the MySQL one. Okay, you can put whatever name that you want. I'm using my channel name. Okay, so let's put the user admin and let's put the password that we choose when we created the database. Here, if you guys have a database, you can put the database name. We didn't choose the database name, so we don't need to put it. And now we have the option to connect to the database. So we take in the port and we put in it here. We're choosing the port that is the default one, and we're testing the connection. And voila, guys, it's working. So now I'm gonna save the setting. And let's connect to the database. Okay, so we are in. We are in the database. Now we're gonna create a database in order for us to import all the SQL file that I just downloaded. Let's call it Word. Okay, as you see, the database is empty. Okay, I'm gonna use import from SQL file. Use the file that I extracted a few minutes ago. And it's gonna take a few seconds. And that's it, guys. You have your new AWS RDS MySQL database server ready for you. You import a new database to it, you connect to it through MySQL client, and you can use it and do whatever you want. Very easy, very simple, right? I know, that's why I'm doing that. Okay, let's see the monitoring. We see the CPU start to move. Database connection, memory, the storage, everything is working. Our database is live and we can connect to it. Okay. Next step for us basically is I'm gonna show you how you can do it from EC2 instance. Okay, how you can connect to your database from EC2 instance. Okay, or from any server you have and you want to have the option to connect to your database. Okay, so this is my EC2 instance that I created a few videos ago. You can watch the video how you can create your own AWS EC2 instance for free. What I'm going to do, I'm going to take the private IP and I'm going to open me the option to connect to the new AWS RDS server from the security group. Okay, I'm going to allow my server IP to interact with the AWS RDS server. Okay, cool. This is how you control who can access your server, your database, everything with the security group. Okay, now let's connect to the EC2 instance itself. Okay, I need the EC2 URL. Okay, I'm taking the EC2 domain name and using the SSH command. You're probably familiar with that. If not, you can learn. Okay, great, we successfully SSH to our EC2 server. And now I'm gonna show you how you can import SQL file or SQL database from your EC2 server to your AWS RDS database. Okay, I'm gonna show you how you're gonna import and connect to it. Okay, so first of all, I'm gonna download the database from the link I shared with you earlier. So let's create a folder, local folder, to download the file. Okay, I'm gonna use a wget. Okay, the file, the zip file is downloaded. I'm gonna extract it now. Okay, great. So we have the zip file and we have the folder we extract. And now we can see that the SQL file. Perfect. So what we need to do now, we need to connect to the RDS server. Okay, this is the command that we're gonna use. We're gonna use MySQL. We're gonna put dash u, admin is the username, p is the password, and minus h is the host, okay, the endpoint. We're gonna put the password. And so simple, right? We connected to our AWS RDS server very fast. So this is the database we have right now. We have the first database that we created, world. Now I'm gonna create another database, world 2. Okay, perfect. Let's use this database. Great. As you can see, there is no table, it's empty. And now I'm going to show you how you can import database to your MySQL database. How you can import a dump file. You just use the command source and the dump file name. And that's it. Show me the table. Bam! Bam, 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 bam. Thank you for watching, guys. If you have any questions, please leave a comment and please like, subscribe for more amazing content.